Hi, and welcome back. Today we're going to learn how to load test data into our developer sandbox. Whenever we refresh a developer sandbox, it doesn't contain any data in it, and we need data to test the applications that we're developing. We're going to learn how to generate test data from a tool called Mockaroo and load leads, accounts, and their related contacts into our developer sandbox for testing. So let's hop over to Mockaroo and see how that tool works. So here I have configured a series of fields that I need. This first export is going to be for our leads. So I've got first name, last name, email, street, city, state, zip, and company. You can add other columns if you want to. And you can also even filter for only certain states if you wanted to only get those out. Then I am specifying that I want 100 rows, and I will click generate data. I will open up my file over here, and we can see that we have a perfectly good file to import into Salesforce for leads. So I will save this. All right, we have that saved as a CSV file, and that will be our lead insert. I'm going to then do a second export, and this will be our account and contact data. Click generate data. And here I have my second file, and I will save this. Okay, so now we have our two files. Now we're going to use Data Loader to load these records into our sandbox. I will provide a link to both Mockaroo and Data Loader in the description below. We're going to run an insert, and we're going to choose the lead object. And this one's really easy because we can just do a straight insert of our leads. Click OK. And now we need to map. I'm going to auto map the fields, and then I'm going to check out and see how well it mapped on its own. So I need to go ahead and map first name and last name, and then my zip code. Okay, so that's all my columns mapped. Then we should get a success message here. Yep, we're all set. Okay, so our leads have gone into Salesforce. Let's just go check those out. I'm gonna go to my leads tab, and then I have a list view called today's leads that is filtered to only show the leads that were created today. And I can see, let's make sure we have 100 leads that were created today. So that's perfect. Everything went in perfectly. Now we need to insert our account and contact. So that's going to require two inserts. So the first one will be our account insert, and the second one will be our contact. So we'll first do an insert on the account. And then we will map our fields. So here, let's see here. All right, I don't want to map my ID. And I'm going to map billing city and the billing state, street, postal code, and let's see what else. I need my account name. Do not need to map email, last name, or first name. I will hit okay. All right, so we have 100 accounts that were inserted. I now need to view this success file. All right, so you can see here, to make sure that you guys see this. So I had a column in my file called ID. And one of the things that happens in Data Loader is if you have a column named ID and you have, or you have a column named status, Data Loader is going to overwrite those columns with the ID of the record that was created during insert or the record that was updated or inserted during an upsert. The status will be updated to be item created. So if you have a status field in your file that's important that you need back out in the success file, make sure you rename status to something else as well as ID. Okay, so we are going to rename this ID account ID. And then this is going to be our contact import. So I will delete this status column and then I will save this as a new file. We'll call this contact insert. Okay, so then I'll get Data Loader back out and I will run an insert on my contact and I will grab that contact insert file. We'll auto match and I'm just gonna map my account ID, my email, my first name and my last name. Well, let's also do the address fields too. We'll do mailing city, mailing state, street, zip. Okay, all right, we're all set. That's all the columns we need to map. We have a success. We are all set. Let's check this out and just make sure some of this data imported correctly. So if I go to one of these companies, let's see. Okay, at Daniel Inc., I should have two contacts. I should have Natalia and Shepard. So let's go check that out. Oh, I imported duplicates, duplicate accounts. This is good for you to see. Yeah, we should have deduped our file before we imported our accounts because we have two accounts that are duplicates right here. But that's okay. This is just test data. We're not going to worry about it. All right, let's go check this out. I'm going to put the ID right at the end here for the account. Okay, and we're expecting to see Natalia here. And then the address should be 191 Elliott Trail. There we go. The address looks correct. Let's look at Natalia. Make sure the address is on the contact there as well. And it is. All right, so we have our test data. We are all set. Well, that's it. That's a wrap. We hope you enjoyed this video on how to load test data into your sandbox. If you like this video, please be sure to like, share, and subscribe to Blue Tiger Academy. And if you want to see us do tutorials on other Salesforce topics, be sure to let us know in the comments below. We'll see you next time. Take care. Bye.